Welcome back to Let's Play Disco Elysium Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. I'm gonna talk to these people in here. This guy. I wanted to see if anybody heard a shot. What is it about the way he carries himself? Failure. It's a sports. He's a sports guy. All about that physical prowess and athletic skill. Nothing else here. Oh well. These people.
Oh, hello, sweetie. So nice to see you again.
Nothing new there.
Hello, officer. I think I almost have it. A new trap design, that is. I know you're skeptical, but I have a good feeling about this.
Right. I had a chat with this kid, Kuno. He promised to stop stealing the locusts. The cryptozoologist purses his lips. So it was just a child. He looks crestfallen. Thank you for telling us, sweetie. Lena turns to smile gently up at her husband. This is good news, right? It means we can try again. Drama says she acts chipper, but something's changed in her tone. A hidden worry. Yes, you're right, he says. We just need to restock the empty trap, then we'll need to inspect the traps one more time, and then maybe we can. The aging cryptozoologist breaks into a hideous coughing fit. Oh boy. She looks at him with tender concern. Darling, I told you to take it easy. You're getting sick. Maybe it's time to go home? You're right. He breathes carefully, trying not to start coughing again. We can come back next season when it's warmer. Rhetoric says, that's just something people tell themselves when they fail. Cause me times that we're reversing your health. Damn it, maybe I can still restock the trap for you? Really, it's too much, officer. He starts coughing again. What morale means is we're grateful for your help, she nods to her husband. Oh boy. Here's a fresh batch of locusts. They should slide right down the funnel. And thank you again. We will definitely mention you, should this lead to a discovery. I'm not talking co-discovery, of course, but... Electrochemistry says, wow, co-discovery. You'd be famous. You'd show them all. This does tingle the pleasure center. Well, we don't have an option to tell them we want to be a co-discoverer. Box with locusts. A cardboard box with several rows of little holes in the lid. Though at first glance the box seems perfectly ordinary, upon closer examination it's obvious that it has been prepared with great care. Find the Insulindian phasmid. First, restock the trap you left empty before. The trick is to remember which one it was. Oh, was that last one by the water lock? There's something with that. Or was it the one that they were working on when we found them? Gary and this Morel here. You volunteer to restock the empty trap for the cryptozoologist. They even give you a fresh box of locusts. This could, after some messing around, probably lead to the discovery. Maybe. Okay, Gart, how you doing?
Hey, was there something you needed?
He nods in greeting. Suggestion says, well, well, bringing him that new bird sure made a difference in his attitude. Alright, I'm not staying here. No, okay.
Again, I can't believe this shit.
He shakes his head, looking like he is really having trouble believing this shit. Okay. Horse face woman?
What is it?
No. Okay. This guy doesn't speak English. Stay masculine. Door does not budge. Is this... Do we have this before? The cobalt blue surface feels rough to touch. To the touch. The stainless steel is door flush with its frame on every side. Interfacing says old cobalt paint, rough on the fingers. 40-50 years since this was painted, maybe? Visual calculus says it leads to a side building adjacent to this one. The old building next to this, half-ruined. Whatever is behind it must be older. Alright, I really want to get in there. Talk to this guy again.
It's you again. What is it?
Okay, I talked to Classier. Now I need to talk to Ruby. Why? He leans back and regards you with curiosity. Sure, I'm going to level with you. Laudanum induced delirium. Paranormal instinct. Okay. I need to pin this on someone. I've decided to pin it on her. I suspect she killed the victim. Because she's your real leader. You're cuckoo, cop. His smile hides a flash of anger. I'm the only man responsible for this unit. Get with it or screw off. Yeah, only man. She's not a man. Shanky says, yeah, screw off. She's a suspect in another case I'm investigating. A drug smuggling. Sounds like you want to push this steam impala crap on anyone. And now you pick Ruby. Well, not on my watch you won't. Ruby's one of us. We're not going to throw her under your moral intern steamroller. Screw that crap. Shanky says, and screw you too, moral fag. He throws a glance at Titus as the last syllable leaves his lips. The big guy sighs. She is missing, and if you hide from the police in a murder investigation, you become a suspect. That's how it works, guys. That's nothing. That's just legalese. You don't even have a sound theory. He crosses his arms. I don't want to be rude, but we're trying to get some R&R here. Think you could get out of here now? Perception sight says, from the corner of your eye, you see a little bird fly into the bush right behind the window behind Titus's back. A bird. Low chance. Present a solid theory about why Ruby could have done it. Plus one if I saw the winch outside. Plus one staged like a plane. Plus one reconstructed murder scene. Probably going to fail on that, but... Yep. Failure. Nothing's happening. The pieces are there, but they remain unconnected. No, no, we can do this. Squint your eyes. Sorry you're not coming up with anything. Again, the pieces are there. She could have done it somehow. Something else. Walla walla bing bang. It's just not coming together. Walla walla bing bang. I don't know what it means, but it felt like the most appropriate thing to say. That's what the witch doctor would say, at least. Why am I such an idiot? No one knows. Alright, damage morale. Give up. There we go. Your mind is a relaxed muscle. It's so nice and easy to give up, isn't it? On the downside, you have no idea what you were supposed to do now. I could have debriefed you. Well, if you put more into logic, we can try that again. I'm okay with 3 out of 4 bars. There's a bird out there. Behind the dock workers, a ceiling height window. The hawthorn branches scrape the glass like bony fingers. There's a little side panel up there to let some air in. No need to open it in spring. It's still too cold outside. Look out the window. We have an even chance for plus one. Mysterious door. Plus one, a bird flew by. Wing beats. Plus one, if you've been here for a long time. Plus two, really you've been here for ages. Success. There's a yellow ribbon tied to one of the branches. Light yellow, faded with time. A tiny splash of color in the blackness of the thicket. Hanging from it, a bronze key. Logic says someone hid the key in the bush and attached a yellow ribbon to make it easier to find. Visual calculus says it's close enough to the latch up there. One can slide it open and just take it. Surely not a coincidence. Okay, well, I'm going to tell them someone hid a key in the bush. Can I just go over there and grab it? I mean, what if they take it? An option. Someone hit a key in the bush, pointing to the window. Huh? The big guy looks behind him. Hand the key. Titus, can you hand the key? Can you let me slide by so I can grab the thing? I don't know about that. Alan, the tattooed man, yawns and settles more comfortably on the bench. I'm comfortable here. Don't think any sliding would really help right now. What a jerk. Glenn says, sorry, looks like you're going to have to go bush diving. Good luck with that. The Hawthorne's got a bitch of a bite. Shanky says, I'm going to enjoy the sight of you in the bushes out there. Theo, with a loud thud, the old man stands up, pushes the window open, grabs the key from the hawthorn branch and slides it across the table to you. Huh? I'm surprised. Take the key. Spare key for workshop. The key is brass. Workshop spare is attached to its bow? Not the bow of the ribbon? The old man closes the window and sits down in silence. Glenn says, come on, man. We're just having some fun. Where's the harm in... Theo says, I'm tired of listening to your crap. Well, that was nice of him. Thank you, to the old man. Don't thank me. The old man takes out his pack of chewing tobacco. I don't give a crap about your key. Does anyone know why this key was hanging right outside the Union box window? Didn't even know it was there. The man looks at the key in your hand, then around the room. Boys? Alan says, no idea. Eugene says, never even seen it. Someone must have hidden it there before this room became our place. Looks at the key. Look at the key in her hand. I wonder what doors does it open. It's an older building. Who knows? Tata shrugs. Empathy says, the shrug is disingenuous. He's intrigued, if only for a moment. Well, that was interesting. Titus doesn't believe Ruby shot the hangman. Present a theory. Make him see it's something to consider. When I can level up something. Skill points 1. I think I'm going to hold on to it for now. But I'm wondering if the key goes to this door. I know I'm like mega zoomed in, but... Try the workshop key. The workshop spare key on the door. Nice. The key fits the dimple lock. It takes a bit of effort to turn it after all these years, but then the lock clicks. Dust rises before you like a mist, Inland Empire says. A tomb haunted by regal spirits from distant ages. Oh, there's a thingy. Load it. Oh, okay. Is that a pinball machine? The pinball says Franco-Nigerian. The theme is horses and swords. This pinball is white Diora. The black glass shows a female figure in mourning. A note. NB. The spare key is tied to the bush outside the corner room window. NB. Ooh, 5 real? Nice. Is this... Oh, it's not... I thought the shroud was outlined, too. Alright. Oh, done. Missing insects case. Oh, done in the door, right? This sure is exciting. Nothing else to see back here. This small elevator is dimly lit by a bulb that's been glowing for ages. The latticed cage is open, inviting you to step inside. Smells of nougat and sweat. Nougat? Someone like candy bars? Your head brushes up against the ceiling. There's a control panel to your right, and just enough room for 2 people to fit in. You can talk to the elevator. Look at the elevator controls. There are large rectangular buttons, Monter, Descendre, and an international call for emergency assistance. That third one appears to be broken. Okay. So I guess ascend and descend. Encyclopedia says, a small steel plaque reads Halter 800. Halter is a Königsteiner lift company who went out of business a long, long time ago. What were you used for, elevator? The deep scratches on the floor suggest it was used as a freight elevator for transporting heavy machinery and one man. Alright, so I was more like thinking to myself, close the doors and go up. Alright. Exciting. They've been wondering what's back here since almost the very beginning. Small windows taped shut with black plastic. You can't see outside. Boxes of tools and replacement parts line the shelves. Is that speakers? Schematics for a pinball machine, futurism themed. So there's another pinball machine here. The pinball machine has been taken apart and gutted. Logic says, so this is where they brought faulty pinball machines to fix them up. A long time ago, everything is covered with dust now. This used to be a pinball workshop. Yes, Martinez North 22 used to be a pinball arcade. And it has been forgotten. Now there is only one working machine in the main hall. The rest is lost to dust. Looks like they gave up on fixing the pinball machines at some point. Yes, pinball hasn't enjoyed a heyday for 15 or 20 years. Interesting. What's in here? A coat. Pinball maker's coat. Yeah. This dusty old coat used to belong to someone called M. Niflox. Now the note said M... Well, said N.B., I think. Not M.B.? The name is stitched into the silk lining. It smells of moths and ancient engine grease, but fits you perfectly. A strange, lonely emotion fills you when you tighten the belt around your waist. I am doing no such thing, tightening belt around waist. Plus one empathy, plus one hand-eye coordination, which is good. So, just wearing this coat makes you more empathetic. And gives you a better coordination, I guess, because you feel empathy towards the man who had it? He was a lonely man? I don't know. And then plus one hand-eye coordination, I guess, because, you know, pinball, you gotta, you know, be quick. Keep the ball from going into the gutter type thing. But, I don't know, I like this stuff too, so I'm just gonna hold on to the coat and try to remember if I need hand-eye coordination or empathy for something. I'll put it on. Just in case we crash or get unexpectedly killed. What have we got here? Footprints? You clearly see footprints in a downy carpet of dust covering the workshop floor. Someone's been back here recently. Test complete. Explore the whirling secret passages. The dust has not settled again where these footprints have been made. The displacement in this dusty hell tells a story. What does this mean? Neither the footprints nor the dust speak their secrets, but you know it means that someone has been back here. Crouch and study the footprints. Large prints, most likely made by boots. The size is hard to determine. Sole could be bigger than vamp. What's vamp? The soles have left a pattern. Uniform, horizontal lines. This doesn't look like the workers' boots from the hanging, does it? The footprints do not speak. They simply exist here, a product of the dust, just as the footprints outside are a product of the mud and apparently different shoes. Okay, so it appeared before we were asking the elevator where does it go, but we were talking to ourselves. Now I think I'm thinking to ourselves and we're actually talking to the footprints. This print doesn't look like the odd soul. The footprints are of one type. They do not congratulate you for correctly recognizing what type they are not. Okay, let's get up. The footprints are still there. They have told their story. Indeed. I got more done. Explore the whirling secret passages, okay. Wait. This is the door. Class is on the other side. This is with the door you've been trying to get through. This is the bar door you tried to kick in before. Oh, wow. Why would I punch the door? I've unbarred it. So this could be another way onto the roof. But you know, the door from downstairs looks like it hasn't been used, like, in a long time. But, well, we had to really work the key in the lock, but I guess whoever went up here could have really worked the key in the lock as well. Just because you use it once doesn't mean you freed up the thing.
Officer, it's a fine day for questions.
Sure it is. That door there, did you know it leads to a downstairs elevator? I did not. She takes a drag of her cigarette. Do you think that this has something to do with what happened? It's possible. She keeps looking at the door with a worried expression. The wind ruffles her hair. Maybe she knows about this. It's an old pinball workshop. The room back there, this place used to be a pinball arcade. I'm trying to see what she can give away before actually telling her about the footprints. Okay, she smiles. I'm glad someone's had fun. There were tracks on the floor. They're recent. This isn't good. That's all for now. She flicks the ash from her cigarette absentmindedly. Empathy says she's lost in thought. Eyes narrowed, forehead furrowed. More comments about what's behind the door. Something else to find back there? In God's name, wake up. Discuss secret route. Plus one. Drama says, who? What? Dear God, you've been lied to. She could have killed her lover and lied to everyone. She's not candid at all. She's smoke in mirrors and willow wisps. Okay, so I thought I was going to tell her to wake up. Am I making myself wake up? She probably didn't give you her real name either. Why would she? Arrest her immediately before she further entangles you in her web of lies. Your real name isn't Classier Amandu. You wouldn't give me your real name if you're on the run. Okay, her voice cracks suddenly. Like there's a garrote around her neck. Okay, what? Okay, it's not. Good. You can tell me the truth. You log your work every week. It's all transmitted to Common Sir. Common Sir? I couldn't just beg you not to enter my name, so I lied. Like I lied before. Like I did at LCSB. I have to lie all the time. She looks at her hands. Her fingernails are chipped white. I'm so tired of it. Tell me your real name. It's Katarzyne. Oh my god, I don't know how to say this. Katarzyne Alessi? The smile on her face is timid, almost painfully so. Encyclopedia says it's a grad name. Zemesk or Yugograd in origin. Not Occidental at all. Smells of motor oil, tega, economic desolation, and rock music-infused alcoholism. Really? It also makes Class J almost an alacronym for Cartrazine Elysium. Okay. Wait. Class J is an abbreviation of blah. She nods. It was a sentimental thing. I wanted to be more me here this time, so I used my nickname. A nickname? Conceptualization says, who gave you this nickname, Class J? Okay, who gave it to you? A teenage boy, a million years ago. Proceed. Hold on, Cartrazine is not an Aranye name, is it? It's not even Mundi, it's Grad. My parents were Zimsk immigrants, but I'm nationalized, Aranye. All I remember is Aranye. Aranyes. It's killing me with these pronunciations. See silence. Alassi is my father's name. I keep calling you Pelage, gosh. Finally we meet, Cartrazine. She nods. Her round eyes meet yours. They seem moist from the wind on the roof. You're probably not even Miss Aranye 37, are you? I am. Her smile quivers. They can never take my sash and my scepter from me. Drama says, yes, they can, for lying. Drama is very dramatic. Was the passport bullcrap, too? That passport you kept hidden? No, it's submerged in a plastic buoy on the coast in the reeds. It doesn't say Classy Amandu. It says Anouk Meyer-Schmidt. It's fake, too? She nods. A fake passport and visa given to me by my employer. I can't even use them. My employer probably leaked the name to hurt me. Why? I didn't show up to a rendezvous. They don't take that lightly. She rushes to explain. I didn't show up because I was afraid they'd do something to me. The job was finished. I'm just a liability now. Empathy says she fears an arrest right here and now. This has been an awful turn of events for her. Where is this buoy? West of the boardwalk, in the reeds, on the coast there. She points toward a clump of ruins on the western horizon. I put it there when I first arrived. Haven't been there since. I'm not sure I could even find it now. It's useless. West of the boardwalks, in the reeds? I need to check this buoy out. Inspect Clashier's buoy. Sounds wrong, doesn't it? You're welcome to it. It's in the reeds northwest of here, past a broken sewage pipe, right near the waterline. Okay, northwest. Enough. She nods, her back straight, ready for whatever is next. You know, I think you didn't make that call to the station. I did. She takes a step forward. What is this? I called your desk, or whatever it is. The numbers are all over town. Call 8102 for emergencies. There was an older woman on the other end. It sounded like she was smoking. She took my complaint. She coughed. Encyclopedia says that is the emergency's desk number. Drama says anyone can know that, sire, by looking around and calling the desk. I don't believe a single word she says. Anyone could know the number, and that someone coughed. It means nothing. I can give you the time, too. It was late. After midnight. 12:20, she breathes in. I know I have not been 100% truthful with you, but I am now. Oh no, I don't want to arrest her. Not yet. Let's change the subject for the time being. She slowly lights another cigarette and steadies her breath, as if in the presence of some tiger. Half-Life says, you are. This is not the end of this. I am a tiger. I need my partner here. Let's get back to those lies you told. Lies I... She repeats, then trails off. It's unclear what she intended to say. Drama says, yes, we demand she be punished for deceiving us. We demand her anxiety. We demand her fear. I'm not going to arrest her, so let's return to this later. Let me check in here again. All we have is that someone was here recently. Oh. It's back Classier's buoy. There is a buoy west of the boardwalk on the coast, somewhere in the reeds. It has Miss Aranier's fake documents in it. We can go down either way. Let's go down this way. Did we close that door? It's already closed. All right. Yes, sleeping is awesome. Oh. And this door is always closed, I guess. Until now. Can I talk to Guard about this? Because I did ask him about what was back there.
Hey, was there something you needed?
Guard, what if I told you I got into the back room behind that blue steel door? Oh? Okay. Well, he controls his excitement well. I did hear you make noise back there, so good for you. Aren't you going to ask me what's back there? Okay. What is back there? A mausoleum of the dead. The black gaping maw at the end of time. Okay, pinball machines. Pinball workshop. Ha! I knew it. I've always wondered where those machines by the door came from. And they told me there was some kind of pinball thing here, too. I knew it. He repeats. Were there any back there? In working order, I mean? Why? Do you want to play? Because I might be up for a game. No, I was just wondering. He appears to be making a calculation in his head. If you found pinball machines there... Drama says he was wondering about something business-related. About how much money he could make off one. Thinking of turning this place back into a pinball arcade? He scowls. No, but we could diversify the entertainment options. Seeing as you've opened the door back there, the machine we have in the corner now is broken. It wouldn't hurt to get a little life in here, other than the hellish karaoke machine. That one's always causing trouble. Logic says, yeah, those numbers he's adding up must be making good sense to him right now. Alright, never mind. I don't want to change what we did. Righto. Did I tell Titus about this? You know what? Wait a second. Now we'll tell Titus about this.
It's you again. What is it?
Oh, I'm looking at all these people. I didn't want to do all this. Ruby is missing, obviously. These seven were the actors on the crime scene. The footprints were theirs, but there's a discrepancy. Ruby, exactly, but none of this is news to you. Stood there for about 4 seconds, not saying anything. Time to move on. Okay, we've got a high chance now. Plus one found key in Union Box. Plus one saw the winch outside. Plus one staged like a play. Plus one reconstructed murder scene. And plus three for secret route found. Present a solid theory about why Ruby could have done it.